homework, work, school, homework, work, sleep, school. Every high school student struggles with schoolwork. So how do those with paying jobs cope? 16% of high school students have jobs, and 32% had jobs in 1990. Is there a reason for the decrease in the amount of high school students with jobs? What are the effects of a paying job on high school students? Does it prepare them for the real world, or does it ruin their grades, making them less prepared for the real world? In this documentary, we will ask students, parents, and teachers what they think about high school students with jobs, and we will discover what it means for their grades and for their future.
I wouldn't, if you have a lot of money and your parents have a lot of money, don't get a job.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't agree with that.
What are your thoughts, Sean?
I think if you don't have a job and you're in high school, you're doing something wrong.
That's true, but I'd rather be a mooch.
Yeah. No, I mean, if you're really rich, like real, real rich,
that's what I'm talking about.
Don't get a job.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Not like if your parents have enough money to like live. Like if your parents have like way more than enough money, do not get a job.
Don't do that. But if you go to Haverford, you're in Haverford High School and you don't have a job.
Get a job
because you're doing something wrong.
Some students work right to contribute to, you know, what the family brings in, or some students work so that they don't have to ask people in the family for money to, you know, get clothes or do things that they want to do. I think that some of our students definitely work to help the financial situation of the family.
I use most of my money on myself, and then I also give some to my parents if they ever need help. Then I'll buy like my sister's stuff. So it's kind of just like extra money that I have around when I want something or my parents need something.
I'm definitely, in my 7 years of teaching, especially at my old school that I taught at up in Allentown, you know, the urban demographic, a lot of them were working nights and in some cases for their families, you know, to succeed and actually have, you know, their income, you know, boosted because the kids are working, and a lot of them had huge responsibilities as far as contributing to their family. So I definitely saw that affecting schoolwork, attendance. Sometimes they would totally take their job and go there instead of coming to school. So I have seen that effect. In Haverford, because it's a different demographic here and a different type of income level for the average, I would say, I don't see it as much at all. I wouldn't really know, to be honest, at this point, but it seems like it's okay.
I don't know, everything, I buy all my stuff.
So you spend it all on yourself?
Yes.
Exactly.
It sounds so selfish.
She's like, yes.
Senior week. My senior week things.
Anything else?
Food.
Yeah, I'd probably say we go like
a lot of food.
Food.
Definitely. Okay. Do you spend most of your money on yourself?
Yeah, I do.
Not even a lie.
Yeah.
I think that the priority for a high school student, unless their family is in a financial situation where the student has to work and has to make money to help support their family, I think working comes secondary, school comes first. So a student should always have time after school to complete homework. So if the job gets in the way of that and they don't necessarily have to have the job, then they probably shouldn't, or they should work more on the weekends.
Having a job interferes with schoolwork and social life because you kind of have to pick between like which ones are more important. So like either you get your schoolwork done and you have a job and then you don't hang out with your friends, or like you have a job and do your schoolwork and don't hang out with your friends. Or did I just say that?
Yes. I don't let it interfere with my homework because school comes first. Right, Jim?
Yeah.
Does having a job interfere with your homework or schoolwork?
Not really.
I have seen students who maybe work too much in the evening and don't have enough time to complete homework, or work too much maybe over the weekend and then come in for school on Monday or on Tuesday and feel tired. They haven't, you know, had any downtime. So I think you have to really balance work and school, and that's just like any one of us would have to do. It's the same thing when you're adult, you have to balance your time.
Definitely. Having a job like screws up my whole schedule. With homework, I have to come home, do my homework at night.
Dos, tres, cuatro.
Make money on a regular basis as opposed to not making money at all.
Yeah.
Well, the best part about having a job is probably just constantly having money. Not having to worry about not having any money.
What are the cons?
Pros of having a job are you can interact socially with the customers or clients. You get paid that cash money, hookah, and
that's
about it. I like
having money from jobs. Not much, to be honest with you.
The thing that I don't like about having a job is that I usually have less time to spend with like my family or my friends.
The other things about having a job, you lose some free time.
You don't. Probably about you it. Don't have fun while you're there.
No, you don't have any fun.
You smell bad sometimes.
Real bad.
Cons of having a job are you have to put in the work and the time, and sometimes you may not want to, but you have to because it's your commitment. But it's all good in the end because you get that cash money kuka.
Does having a job interfere with you?
Now that we have seen the perspective of students and teachers about students with jobs, we will see how parents approve or disapprove of their children's study habits along with their work.
She misses school a lot. Can't get up in the morning. It hasn't affected any grades.
How many hours do you want your child to work?
At least 20. A week. 20 hours a week. Kayla spends more money on herself than I do.
It's great if you can work in high school. I know I had a job in high school, and it does teach you a lot about responsibility and how to manage your money and manage your time. Just to be able to start to contribute to your own financial security so that you're not always asking your parents for money to go out to the movies or whatever you want to do. It's nice to have that independence if you're able to fit it into your schedule.
If they have some credit issues and they need to make up some credits, getting a job is a good idea as long as it doesn't interfere with schoolwork, because they can get credits and make money.
Have jobs while in high school.
I would recommend that if they feel comfortable with their schoolwork and to an extent that they can, you know, have the spare time to do it, I think it'd be a great idea to have a job. I think it teaches you about what you want to become later on in life, kind of. I know I did dishwashing for like 2 weekends and figured out that wasn't so hot. So there are some really great lessons to be learned if you have a job. I think it's a great thing.
If you have to get a job, like you want money for yourself, I would recommend working. But if you don't need to, then don't work, because then it's a waste of time.
If a student works 200 hours, they get one credit, and they can get up to 4 credits in a year. So they can work 800 hours and get 4 credits for 1 year. You can't get any more than 4 credits. And where Mrs. Vindler is, she does the work study. So we have a counselor specifically here for work study coordination. So students who have part-time jobs can get credit.
I definitely, in my 7 years of teaching, especially at my old school that I taught at up in Allentown, you know, the urban demographic, a lot of them were working nights and in some cases for their families, you know, to succeed and actually have, you know, their income, you know, boosted because the kids are working. And a lot of them had huge responsibilities as far as contributing to their families. So I definitely saw that affecting schoolwork, attendance. Sometimes they would totally take their job and go there instead of come to school. So I have seen that effect. In Haverford, because it's a different demographic here and a different type of, you know, income level for the average, I would say, I don't see it as much at all. I wouldn't really know, to be honest, at this point, but it seems like it's okay. I think students with jobs are a great thing. I think it teaches them responsibility and meeting deadlines, which are two adult skills that you really need to have in the real world. I do see it affecting and, you know, kind of stressing students out when it comes to, you know, workload and whatnot. And I know myself, I made sure I worked, but in the summertime or the weekends, I didn't try and interfere with my schoolwork as much just because that was really for me.
Jobs in high school can definitely interfere with each other, but it seems that there are ways to work around that. While jobs may take away free time, they are a supply of money and independence. If high school students have jobs, they must learn how to balance their time, which is a valuable skill in the future. Ultimately, it is the student's choice as to whether they will have a job. If they want to learn how to balance their time and have experience in a job, they should. But if they want to focus on schoolwork in order to sharpen their mind in other ways, they may also do so. As long as they're happy, in the end, it should all lead to a good life and a good career.